3.
Yeah.
Dang, they're playing sloppy.
Oh, Kentucky. Well, now I can charge. I know I can charge my phone on my mixing board.
Yeah.
I just figured,
You just figured that out?
Yes, I did.
Really?
All right, folks, we're going to get ready for our national anthem, and then the malarkey will start. It's Rossford and Fostoria. Should be a good one tonight.
And here we go.
And abide by high standards of conduct, competition, and relations with member schools. The athletes in this game are friendly rivals. While play may be fierce, all in attendance are reminded this is a game between young athletes and that good sporting behavior is expected. Ladies and gentlemen, we live in a country with freedoms like no other. To honor America and in respect for all who have served this great country to defend those freedoms, please stand. Remove your caps for the playing of our national anthem performed tonight by the Rossford High School Pep Band. The officials for this game have been selected and assigned according to the procedures adopted by the Ohio High School Athletic Association and the Northern Buckeye Conference. Tonight's officials, Tom Gibbons, Douglas DeSilver, and Al Davis. Now, ladies and gentlemen, let's meet the starting lineups for this evening's contest. First, the visiting Fostoria Redmen. A 6'2" junior, number 0, Makai Johnson. A 6-foot senior, number 2, Aiden Spring. A 6-foot-2 junior, number 5, Dylan Holmes. A 6-foot-2 junior, number 11, Christian Carter Stokes. And a 6-foot-3 junior, number 22, Jordan Ferguson. The Redmen head coach, Tom Lumen. Thank you. 6'4" senior number 20, Garrett Murphree. A 6'1" senior number 12, Brandon Swole. A 6' senior number 3, Wes. A 6'4" junior, number 21, Jay Morrison. And a 6'9" junior, number 22, Derek Morris. Your Bulldogs head coach, Brian Schwartz.
They got the jams on tonight, don't they, Mick?
Sure do. Hey, we're coming to you here from Rossford High School here on Joe Stalma Court. As the Rossford Bulldogs set to take on the Fostoria Redmen, I am Mick Gonzalez. He is Mike Jameson. Buckle up. This should be fun.
Well, I'll tell you what. Coach Forrest has done a little changing up in the lineup here, bringing Ellison in and Swopes and... I don't see Rebels right now. Don't know what's going on with that, but Ellison's got to have a nice night, and Murph's got to be able to hit that three tonight to make things happen. Fostoria is a much better team than they were a year ago, Mick.
Yeah, this is true. Well, the opening tip goes to the home team. And, of course, you got to remember, too, the other dangerous threat. Everyone looks at 22 in white, thinking, you know, he's the big man out there, as that one does not go. Rebound grabbed here by Jordan Ferguson.
Oh, first, Ferguson, he walked.
Whoa. Either I think they're going to call a foul.
Yeah, maybe. Yep, yep.
Well, I was going to say, everyone thinks that, you know, you see Derek Vorst out there. He's the big guy that stands above everyone else. So he's just going to stay under the boards and that's it. Nope. That young man likes to shoot from outside. He's not afraid to try to shoot the three.
This is going to be a quickness factor for Rossford tonight, because if there's anything that Fostoria has been able to do, it's been able to move things quickly.
Yep.
Trapping real quick there now, too. But that's going to leave somebody open that can shoot the ball.
Yeah. Well, now here is Swope. Into Vorst.
Yeah, Vorst will lead him up.
Triple teamed, and he got stuffed by Ferguson.
That's the man we're going to be talking about tonight, because he was head and feet above Vorst right there.
Jordan Ferguson, my goodness. 6'3", he's a junior, and he has the ball, dishes it off.
Dylan Holmes was able to get it in, but Vorst had some just great defense.
I was
going to
say, he positioned himself, yeah. He blocked him out nicely.
Yeah, he pushed him down out of the key almost, basically.
And a turnover there, Swope steals the inbound pass.
Yeah, they're letting him play a little bit.
Just a little.
Yeah, Johnson should have got dinged on that one.
I was going to say, he's got to pass that off.
Yeah, well, he got caught in a corner there. Bad pass.
Because Fostoria is not afraid to challenge.
No.
They're going to play aggressive on defense.
You know, by far, Rossford is the best team in the Northern Buckeye. Nice shot right there.
Great bucket there from Jake Morrison.
Genoa Bank 3.
No, that's true. I'm used to saying that, though, with Garrett Murphree. I've redubbed him Garrett Murph 3.
Murph 3. Murph's listening tonight. He said he was coming over to the game. I think he might even be down on the bench already. He's working on some little surgery, but everything's cool. Says he's hurting like hell, but he hurts me. He gets that back for never passing me the ball when we play basketball.
Of course.
But, man, did we win a lot of tournaments. Murph was a man. Still is. But. one of our sponsors and helping us make these games happen. And just really one thing, Rossford, and I saw it in the game you guys did last week, the Collider game.
Mm-hmm.
You know, they're just not gelling yet. You know what I mean?
Yep.
They are the best team in this league. There's no, by far, the talent pool is incredible with what they've got here.
But they from just outside.
Yeah, they just couldn't put it together. Oh, how about Ellison?
Beautiful effort.
Oh, that's slow.
Yep. Swope got his own rebound, kissed it off the glass, and it's 5-0 home team.
As long as they can keep themselves out of foul trouble, now there's Morrison with the steal. That'll happen all night.
And
on the floor.
Yep, so that bucket wouldn't have counted. So, but the foul will be on Aiden Sprang. He's another young man that I remember him from football.
Oh, yeah. Had the pleasure of doing some Fostoria games. Very nice to us down there. Murph for three.
Nope. And the ball ping pongs, and it's picked up by the Bulldogs.
You know,
now Swope, more methodical.
Swope is the Bulldog. I mean, by far, you know, he's a little hairy Bulldog. He just does a nice job, and he's in the right place at the right time. Dedicated defensive person, and that's why he's in there right now.
Morse dishes it off, and Morrison, nice move to the bucket.
All night.
Morrison. Right now, a converted touchdown is the lead for the Bulldogs.
Your little faux pas, I love them.
Faux pas? What mistake did I make?
I have the flu.
Just a cross reference. Yeah. I crisscrossed my metaphors.
There you go. I could have thought of that, but.
Yeah. That one was knocked away out of bounds from Jake Morrison, so it'll still remain Redmond ball. We have got 3:41 to go here in this opening quarter.
Yeah, we apologize for not having a clock tonight, but folks, I got to tell you, I've had 102 fever for the last 4 days, and today it finally broke. So, and then my truck broke, so it's sitting in my other truck right now. So I apologize. We don't have.
I'm not worried about it. I don't think anyone else is, as long as we keep telling them.
There you go. Oh, he stepped out of bounds. Yes, he did.
Yep, Holmes stepped out on that line.
Took him a second to blow that whistle.
As long as he blew it.
I'm not 100%, but I think my buddy's down there right now. Mr. Zach. It looks like Mr. Zach down there.
O'Brien?
Yep. Played golf with him on July 4th in the big July 4th tournament with Scott Winkowski. Scott, of course, is helping us out with all of our endeavors here now.
Oh, that pass. Well, it's going to be returned right back, and here is Rebels. It's hard to believe Brendan Rebels is a senior now.
I know.
Here's the feed inside.
That's Vorst. It.
You know, and that's the cool thing. Although that shot was short, they're using Vorst kind of as a decoy.
Sure.
They go inside, and every time you think he's going to go to the bucket because of his height advantage, he kicks it back out to one of his teammates to get a clean shot off.
Ferguson's the man. They want to get that ball into Ferguson. And him and Vorst, that's not going to make a good competition for Ferguson.
So although it wasn't a good one for Vorst earlier.
That's true.
To be fair.
I'm not homering, right? I can't homer.
You can homer.
I can homer a little bit.
I try to be fair.
Timeout.
But a timeout on the court here is 2:25 left to go here in quarter number one. 7-0 right now, Rossford.
Genoa Bank is celebrating 120 years. Hi, I'm Marty Sutter, President and CEO of Genoa Bank. Since 1902, Genoa Bank has been caring for the financial needs of our neighbors. Our roots remain as we continue to serve our customers, our communities, and our families. Genoa Bank celebrates 120 years by reflecting on our past and, more importantly, focusing on our future. We will continue to make a positive difference in the lives of those who work, bank, and invest at Genoa Bank.
Do you guys like the new music they play now?
Well,
no.
No. I'm old. You know, I'm used to, I mean, to me, too new is Jock Jams, so.
That probably what we just heard was on Jock Jams, too. Mm-hmm.
Nothing would surprise me. If that one was knocked out of bounds, it'll remain Fostoria ball.
Truman's getting in with us here. Go Blue. Oh, jeez. I'm going to have to put up with him without you this week, you know?
Yeah, I know, but it'll be okay.
Oh, he's going to be.
Well, he called my show on Sunday.
Did he?
Yes. He wanted to know if you were there.
Oh, because I'm there all the
time.
Yeah,
apparently. But, no, he.
Should I be sick for Saturday?
No. Just, hey.
It is what it is.
Exactly. That three doesn't go. Rebound grabbed over there by Garrett Murphree. Morrison feeds Vorst.
There it is.
Garrett
Murphree. A little short.
Yeah, he's a little short there today.
So far. He'll find it, though.
Rebels in the corner for three. In and out. Swope with the rebound.
Ah.
Wow, threw a moonshot all the way back out to
I'm
Morrison.
With you on that one. Now you should talk.
I was going to say, Swope had an open three there.
Yeah. There must be strict rules now.
Yeah, I was going to say.
Tuesday's
they must have
practice that said there's. Oh.
Oh, and. Rebels is just going to let it roll out of bounds. Over and back. But they did eat a lot of time off the clock.
Let me ask you, why?
If he handles it, it's over and back. And he just let it go because nobody from Fostoria was rushing to get it.
Gotcha.
Because they knew he was going to scoop it up.
Hey,
so.
you're on the road all the time. Sheets is announcing they plan to expand to Toledo. Have you ever eaten at a Sheets?
No. But they are good. I've heard nothing
what
but.
What kind of stuff do they have?
It's kind of, I'll say, you've heard of Wawa's?
No.
Have you? Okay, you've heard of Bucky's.
Yeah.
Okay, Sheets is basically like a. I don't want to say watered down because that makes it sound like I'm being negative towards Sheets.
I just want to know what kind of food they'll have.
They've got plenty of snacks that you'd see at a gas station. We're under a minute to go,
is
by the way.
Is it a gas station?
Yeah.
Oh.
It's like a gas station store.
Gotcha. Well, never mind. That's all we needed to know.
Like, think
oh,
in your... Oh,
nice.
Beautiful feed.
That's
first bucket of the night.
That's how you do it.
Exactly what they needed. Brian O'Neill. Not the actor. Vorst let go with one from long distance. No good. Out of bounds. It's going to go to the Bulldogs.
34 seconds.
Christian Carter Stokes wasn't too happy about that. Fought for that rebound and went off of him. Well, now they're going to give it to Fostoria.
Huh.
The official originally pointed to it being Rossford ball. But change their mind. So Fostoria can close the gap here.
Oh, another
or
steal.
Not.
It's Ellison again.
Oh. Go. Tried to get cute with that pass.
Yeah.
And it went off of Jake Morrison out of bounds. Christian Carter Stokes will inbound. Trying to save up time. 16 seconds to go.
Tell you what, I was over at Danny's now, and I know they're watching the game tonight. Chili dogs, phenomenal.
That shot too strong. It goes out of bounds.
3 seconds. Anything can happen right now.
That's true.
I got to give props out to them because the place looks great. They're doing some great stuff with it. But they do one thing that makes impressive. They chop their onions real fine.
Oh.
You know what I mean?
Yep. I know exactly what you mean.
So much better when they do that. Just so much better. So great, great chili dog there. My buddy Dave had a hamburger, bacon cheeseburger, very good. And place is really looking good. Brad and his gang have done a wonderful job over there. And thanks for helping out with us getting these games in. You guys, Moe's, you know, just great people.
Good support there.
I had some real good bean soup over at Moe's today.
And they're going to call a cheap foul there on Derek Forrest. He didn't need that. Didn't need to do that one.
I mean, seriously, you got to front him. You know, when you have a play set up like that, you got to get in front of him because they're going to ding you every single time. Now they're going to have a shot here. Ferguson going to take a nice three.
Right at the buzzer. No. Does not go. Well, a low-scoring affair in the first quarter, as after one, it is Rossford 7, Fostoria 2. This is the Toledo Sports Network.
Danny's Cafe Rossford is open and ready to make your holiday special with great drinks, food, friends, and watch all your favorite sports on our 17 big screen TVs. Some of the best entertainment in the area. Great food and all your favorite beers. Danny's Cafe in historic Rossford on Main Street. Stop by and say hi to the friendly people at Danny's Cafe in Rossford.
Welcome back here to Joe Stalma Court inside of Rossford High School. As right now it's 7-2. We head to the top of the second. Ba-dum-bum. Fostoria will start with the ball. This is Johnson. Ooh, nearly stolen. Johnson drives, his shot is short. Rebound grab by Johnson.
One thing they got to worry about with Fostoria is their quickness, and it's showing right now, Mick.
Yep, they're just not finding the bucket right now. That's the difference. Right.
Ball handling is much better on the Rossford side, but the tenacity, I'll tell you what, They're getting the job done.
Fostoria is matching.
Yep.
That shot doesn't go. Nice save there by Morrison.
Yeah, he's all over it. As long as he doesn't get into any kind of foul trouble, because, you know, it just depends on how they're calling it at night, because he's really wreaking havoc on the guys that are around him.
Here now is nice move to the hole by Vorse, but
he's going to get two out of that.
Yep, he gets fouled, so they'll go to the line. Christian Carter Stokes picks up his first foul.
At the line with two shots for 22, Derek Ford.
Ooh.
Yeah, this has been a constant problem with the Bulldogs, their foul shooting. Their foul shooting is just, you know, it's anemic.
Yeah, their last game, it was.
Oh, yeah. I got the second.
Vorse goes 1-for-2. 6-point lead for the Bulldogs.
Oh, nice move by Ferguson.
And that
just
one does
can't
not
make it
go,
happen.
Man. It's like there's a. It's like almost like there's a.
Don't say it. Don't
okay.
say it.
Okay. Just going to say a pane of glass over the bucket.
I knew you were going to say something plexiglass on me. I knew plexiglass was coming. Boy, they're trapping real nice, though. Fostoria's playing some great defense on them tonight.
Oh, nice. Well, it'll be a jump ball.
Yep. To stay with Rossford.
Great effort over there by Jordan Ferguson. Young man's only a junior. Here's the feed inside. Nice feed from Vorse to Swope, but that bucket does not happen. And here come the Redmen. Ferguson drives, kicks it back outside. Around the arch they go. Johnson for three. No. But we've got a whistle. And we've got a foul. This one will be Fostoria. Looks like Caden Miller picked up the foul for the Redmen. So the Bulldogs will bring it up as it'll be Brendan Revels. As we have 5:40 to go here in the first half. And we're still in single digits on both sides.
Your beloved partner's back. Oh, there you go.
Oh, nice recovery by Morrison as he sinks the easy rebound.
Definitely a defensive battle so far, Mick.
Yep. I mean, we're coming up on 5 minutes remaining in the first half, and we've got one team finally in double digits.
This is kind of like one of our Fed games right now. Except if Murph's playing, because he's hitting threes all night. So.
And right now, Fostoria can't hit anything. Here's Revels.
They're, tell you what, man, their defense has been good. They've been able to shut Force down, wide open. Nice.
Nice fake there from Swope. He faked Johnson right out. Another three attempt. There you go. Nice bucket there from Ryan O'Neill.
I think that's the start of a love story. Nice turn. He's in there. And
back out, Revels. Oh, his pass. Well, picked up there by Morrison. He saved it. Ooh.
I love it.
Beautiful.
Oh, oh wow.
And one. And one.
Yeah, that's Morrison where Jake slow said to, his best.
Slow to get up, but.
Yeah, he got clocked on that one.
He went hard to the basket. And, well, you do that, you know you're going to draw a lot of contact.
At the line, number 21, Jake Morrison. One shot.
And that was three plays. They moved the ball. Got everything around where they're needed.
Well, they're going to take a timeout, I think, right now.
Uh-huh.
So we've got 4:11 to go here in the opening half. And it is 14-5.
We'll just stay here.
All so, right.
Yeah, it's just a 30-second.
Give us a chance to tell you about the sports show that sucks each and every Saturday morning on 100.7, the ticket here in Toledo.
We had belly dancers.
We did, yeah.
That was so cool, though.
That was a lot of fun. Yeah. That was a lot of fun.
That was a good show. Tom Cole, Terry Crosby was in.
Mike Ballman.
Bomber. Kevin Bomber there, you know.
That was a ball.
It was like 4 years ago. You know what
Whatever
I mean?
Whatever it was. Yeah, it was, like it was just good changed. Times. Good times.
Yeah, we had a good time. And we'll probably be at Reset in Perrysburg. I think that's where Jeff's planning on having us. And but you're not going to be there.
No, I'm going to be. I'll try and listen, though.
Here comes Morrison.
Yeah, he completes the traditional three-point play. 15-5 your score.
And 4:01 left.
Well, under four now.
But you always got to be right.
No, I'm not. Just stop it. As they move it around the arc, and we've got a whistle. Fostoria is going to take a full timeout with 3:52 to go. 15-5 your score here on TSNW.
Moe's Place, downtown Rossford, has the best burgers in town and much, much more. Stop by for their famous Flaming Moe Burger. Moe's Place. Proud to bring you Rossford High School Sports.
What can you expect from working with Fairway Independent Mortgage Corporation? Our branch manager, Marty Binn, can help you navigate through the loan process with the service and speed you deserve. Contact Marty today to get pre-qualified. Make your home buying dreams a reality. Call 419-481-8696 to speak with Marty Binn today.
Oh, 3:52 to go here in this first half. Fostoria, I mean, their defense has been stellar tonight. They just can't buy a bucket. They've got 1-2 on a kind of a helter-skelter play, and then they got 1-3 from O'Neill, and that's been it. Two baskets for the whole ball game. So if you're a Rossford fan, you know, or I'm sorry, a Fostoria fan, you know that the Redmen can do better. They've got talent. There's no question. You can see it. And they swing it around the arc. A short bucket. There you go. Aiden Sprang with the deuce. Oh, I'm sorry. That was Makai Johnson that got that. He sinks the deuce. Here now, Rebels feeds inside to Vorst for the easy basket. And we've got another whistle. I think there might be some moisture on the floor.
Time for like a wet nap or something, or a dude wipe. Like my dude wipes.
Is this a TV game? Anyway.
Boy, Dave.
No, there's a, looks like one of the screws came up out of the floor.
Oh. Whoa.
For one of the plates there.
Well, that's not good.
So we may have to get some meat. Yeah, the where they put the volleyball posts and everything in.
Wow.
My goodness. Well, we've seen just about everything. They put tape over it? Okay, I've seen it all now. Looks like a cross from where I'm sitting.
Well, this is the holidays.
Well, yeah, it is Christmas coming up, so anyway.
Feliz Navidad, all that good stuff.
Mm-hmm. Fostoria with the ball. They trail by 10. 2:50 to go.
Well, between that and camera issues tonight, what else can go wrong, right?
Don't ask.
Oh, I know. I shouldn't have said that. Oh, nice reverse. That's.
And good recovery there by Johnson.
Fostoria is playing good ball. They just, you know, just can't make things happen.
Well, they're not finishing.
Right.
That's it. You know, I mean, I have no interest, or not interest. I should say I have no dog in this fight, as it were. But.
Because you're a Cardinal Stritch supporter, right?
Of course. How did you know? Anyway. Nice alley-oop back. You just want to, for competitive purposes,
right.
You want to see them finish. You want to see them get some points on the board.
And they are penetrating. They're being able to do some stuff. But Rossford's defense has just been up to the task so far.
They've been able to move the ball around. They just can't. When they go inside, they can't finish. That's it. And then Rossford.
Oh.
Beautiful rainbow.
Wow.
For the three. Makai Johnson again. Second bucket in the row for the Redmen. It's 17-10.
Got to watch those passes inside Divorce because they're right there waiting for him.
Yep. They're zeroing in on him. Let's see what Morrison can do. Off the glass.
That's what he can do.
Got a nice bounce there as it went in.
Jake's doing it the old-fashioned way. He's taking it to the hole. And, you know, he's not doing too much with the outside shooting right now, but, boy, every time he's been able to penetrate, and they basically can't stop it, and his finger roll's been perfect.
From outside, nope. Well, he had the right idea, but he swatted it out to nobody in particular, so it's going to go back over to Rossford.
That was Gavin Miller with that swat.
Yep.
That swat is brought to you by, we need an exterminator when we have a, that swat is brought to you by.
Raid. Under a minute to go in the half. From outside,
that's
yes.
It. You know, the only reason he got that is his brother just walked by me and I fist bumped him right when he shot that. Nice job, Murph.
Garrett Murphree with the...
Murphree, there you go.
Genoa Bank, three-point shot. Tipped, but, well, here's the steal. Rebels. Wow.
Nothing.
Absolutely
three
nothing.
Guys on him. Somebody's open.
And that's Morrison. He couldn't get it to go.
Oh.
And a foul going to be called on Swope.
Rossford foul, number 12.
11.6 seconds remaining.
So far, a quick game.
Yeah, not much in the way of fouls. Here's Johnson. Under 5 seconds, they got to get that shot off.
Oh. That didn't get
and
it off.
They run out of time.
Well, I almost made it too.
Yep, oh, that's one half in the books here at Rossford. Your score right now here as we head into the intermission is the Rossford Bulldogs 22 and the Fostoria Redmen 10. You're watching high school basketball on the Toledo Sports Network.
At Heban, Murphree, and Lewandowski, we deal with contested wills by breaking down the legal terms involved and making this complex area of law as simple as possible. If you are involved with a case in estate or probate litigation, we would be happy to provide you with our unparalleled legal counsel. Heban, Murphree, and Lewandowski, downtown Rossford. Contact them today at 419-662-3100. Heban, Murphree, and Lewandowski. From the kitchens of Italy to you, Arturos Pizza Kitchen is the home of authentic Italian food. As one of the oldest independently owned pizzerias in Toledo, Arturos Pizza Kitchen has been serving since 1988. With pizza, salads, award-winning subs, chicken chunks and wings, mom's own lasagna recipe, and our famous cheese sticks, we have it all. Never frozen, always homemade. Arturos Pizza Kitchen. Hungry? Call Arturos, 419-698-1641.
You've planned and planned. Each moment of your special day just has to be perfect. You don't want to worry about anything. Just know that you've hired professionals to make your wedding day special. Mike Jameson with Creative Video Imagery has produced award-winning weddings for over 15 years. Our company has the equipment and the artistic ability to capture your day on digital DVD, giving you lasting memories of a day you will cherish forever. Call Creative Video Imagery today or visit our website, Creative Video Imagery, making moments into lifetime memories.
Pro Golf Fairways at Cameo Pizza and Resets in Rossford and Monroe Street right next to Nick and Jimmy. With top of the line golf simulators, duck pin bowling, and the best food for your night out. We've got you covered. It's Pro Golf Fairways with all the greatest golf courses in the area. why not come out and hit a few with us at Pro Golf Fairways at Cameo Pizza and Resets in Rossford and Monroe Street next to Nick and Jimmy.
Hey everybody, it's Steve Taylor from the Taylor Automotive family. It is October. We are back with another month of Free Car Friday. Spooktacular October all month long. And you know, we've already given away 7 vehicles. It's been fantastic seeing the winners' faces, you know, when they actually win that vehicle. I think so many people are just in disbelief that they actually get this car. We cover the taxes, you know, there's no strings attached. They get to drive off with it. We're already in October. And hey, you got a chance this month to win a vehicle. We're giving away more golden tickets. We're gonna be out and about all your fall favorite spots. We talked about McQueen's, we talked about maybe even Cedar Point, Flights's, Gus Brothers, all these places around Northwest Ohio that are just known for fall. Go to our Facebook page. You got to go to the pinned post at the top. You got to like, comment, and share. You guys know the drill by now. We're giving away a great 2016 Kia Rio. Check us out on our Facebook page. Get a chance to win that vehicle. Look for our golden tickets. Follow us on Facebook and have some fun. Maybe you'll win that car at the end of this month. Take care, everybody. We'll see you.
But Rossford's defense really
well. I will say this: in other words, the Redmen had a lot of opportunities inside, but they only had one. They never had like a lot of offensive rebounds.
Right, right, right.
Where they or Rossford had a lot of defensive rebounds,
yeah,
and that made the difference.
And Rossford, most of the time defensively, was able to make them, you know. Fostoria spent a lot of time on offense. They were in their offensive set for a while.
Yeah.
But Rossford made them go to the third and fourth option many, many, many times.
Well, we'll see what kind of adjustments were made at the half. Because
Swopes, Ellison, the big boy. Jake's out there, and Murph.
Ferguson will inbound here for Fostoria to start the third quarter. He's out there with Johnson and O'Neill. Yeah, and Carter Stokes.
You know, we said a lot about Ferguson, and I mean, it's showing him with no points.
Yeah, it's because he's been his. I mean, he stuffed Vorst early in the game,
right.
And then he got a couple of clutch rebounds, but he has not, he's not been able to get on the scoreboard as of yet. Well, here now is Morrison driving. That's been his bread and butter, but didn't go that time. Redman rebound as O'Neill got the board.
I give credit to Redmond, though, because they're playing as a team.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, even with the adversity from the plain and simple fact they can't get things to go in the hole, they're playing real well.
I think so. If they could finish, man, they'd be dangerous.
And they're young, too.
Yeah, they are very young. Lots of juniors. Got a few seniors, but not many. And that one's the bomb down the court. Good save, it turned out to be, as Vorst got his hands on that. It was sloppy, but it was effective.
Oh!
Whoa, Swope went strong to the boards, but missed.
And he went left. I always thumbs up for the left shot.
Mm-hmm.
6-17 in the
as long as you make it.
I'm just all,
it's the
I'm
effort.
All about left. I think the only way to win real big games,
good hustle there, but it's going to go back over to the Redmen.
Is to be able.
Or I'm sorry, to Rossford. They switch ends. I forgot.
Right. I've always just said that where you're going to beat people is being able to be a right-handed dribbler or passer or shooter and be able to take it left. Like that.
Nice feed inside, contact, and a foul. So Swope will go to, or not Swope, but. Morrison will go to the line. Was feeling a little ambidextrous, or dyslexic for a minute there. Not ambidextrous.
Is my stuff wearing off on
apparently.
You? What's that guy's name you always call me?
Norm Crosby.
Norm's Crosby.
Is he any relation to Terry? Oh.
Don't go there. Be good.
I am. I love Terry. Terry's honestly, we after the show on Saturday, we sat down, had a nice conversation, Terry and I, and just absolutely love the guy.
Yep. Can't thank them enough for being a part of everything we're doing now.
Him and the coach, Tom Cole.
Boy, Truman is just on fire today.
Oh?
He's probably been writing these down since the Michigan-Ohio State game. It's...
You know, and I told him on Sunday, I was like, you know.
Yes, Dave.
Michigan deserved the win. Great effort there from Ferguson. But
Swope was the man on that.
Yeah, he took the charge.
I felt his head hit the ground all the way up here.
Yep. That was a great play. He just that he fouled him. Because he went hard to the bucket, went down, and as he was going down, he put the ball up and it still went in. Yep. But it didn't count. But no, I was telling Dave on Sunday, I said, you know, hey, kudos to the Wolverines. They deserve the win.
Yep.
They did what they had to do. They outplayed Ohio State in every facet.
Oh.
Beautiful hook there from Vorst. And, well, here we are. So we'll see what happens. We still got plenty of football to play out yet.
I just think it'd be hilarious if Ohio State winds up getting in it and then winning the whole damn thing.
They did that in 2014.
Never know.
Here now. Ferguson.
My sister said that's the only reason I got sick this weekend.
Ferguson puts it up. No. Hit that flat of the iron there between the backboard and the cylinder. And from outside.
They're talking now.
Big three. Garrett Murphree with the Genoa Bank three-point shot.
There you go.
And the answer back. That was Jason Tucker. First time we've called his name tonight. Murphree trying to go up there again. Can't get it to go. Long distance three. Nope.
Did not need that.
So it's going to go back over to the Bulldogs here with 3:49 to go here in quarter number three.
Yeah, Tucker looked at that more or less as a desperation guy. If we can get this three in, and they didn't need it right there, they could have wrapped it a couple more times and got themselves a better look.
We'll see what happens here.
Looks like Fostoria's back in there man-to-man.
They tried to feed it to Vorse on the alley-oop, but the pass was behind them. They usually try that once a game at least, that backdoor feed with the alley-oop.
They make it once a game. Well, when you got a 6'9 guy on your team, you might as well use them, right?
Yeah. Man. Tucker had that open, or Ferguson had that open look at that three and did not. That's going to go over to Rossford.
Revels did a nice job on that one. All our people over at Moe's and Danny's, hope they enjoying the game tonight. And on the big screen TV there, we thank them for all the support. And both places just phenomenal food and drink and have a good time and love them to death. It's just opening up Rossford.
Yep.
So nice. And
a lot more options.
Yep. Very nice. Very nice. Man.
Muscling his way through for the bucket was Vorst. Now it's 28-12.
Now Dave's just calling me a hypochondriac, so.
And that three attempt from O'Neill misses the target and goes out of bounds. Some of the Rossford students are going
here
and are giving a little chin music there to O'Neill.
Folks, I'll tell you what, good game tonight. We need to see some more Rossford people here.
Yep.
We need to load it up. They got some great games coming up. They're actually going to be down in Elmwood on Friday night.
And Saturday, they're back here against Defiance.
Yep.
And then a week from Friday, they're home to Lake.
Yeah, we'll be here for that one. We won't be here Saturday's game.
Oh, the one with Detroit U-Prep?
No, we'll... I hadn't gotten that far out, but this week is Defiance, December 3rd.
Uh-huh.
I have to work that day.
Okay.
Then Lake, we'll do the Lake game. We're going to try and get the we'll see what we're going to do.
Yep.
That Detroit U-Prep will probably, that's only varsity, and that's like 3:30 on the 10th.
Okay. Here's Revels driving. Doesn't get there, but he's fouled, so.
Oh, Elmwood got moved to the 14th. Cool. Thank you. That's the 14th for the boys' game. Gotcha. Well, we'll do the girls' game this Thursday night. They'll be playing. We'll go down to Elmwood for that. I love going to Elmwood. They take very good care of us down there.
Good people down there, yep. I'll tell you what, everywhere we go, pretty much everyone is really good to us. I'm really grateful for that.
Well, you know, we got the Hall of Famer,
Glenn Forbush.
Glenn Forbush. I don't think we'll have him that night because he's in a band. But look at that.
One doesn't go.
I'm Mr. Grinch.
2 minutes to go here in the quarter.
Yeah, I'm glad we got this one in tonight because this weekend just a lot of craziness going on. And Friday night we won't be able to do a game. Christmas parties, you know how you get into a million of them. There's Ferguson. Yeah, he got caught up with Swope there. But up.
Nice block there by Morrison.
No, that was Vorse.
Was that Vorse? I didn't see him. I was watching Morrison.
We got to get that third eye fixed on you, you know?
Yeah.
Cyclops Gonzalez.
That's me. Redmond with the ball.
I don't think Coach Vorst is, he's got who he's working with right now, and not going to love what happened in that Kaleida game, and the guys are playing great defense.
Yeah, because it was around this time that Kaleida made their move and came back to win it.
And just nailed every one of their foul shots.
Yeah, I mean, they couldn't hit anything in the first half, and then in the second half, they couldn't miss.
Yep.
So we're under a minute to go here. And right now, Fostoria, it's great that they're moving the ball around. The problem is, though, is that we got a quarter of basketball left and you're down 17.
32 seconds.
That one goes in and out. Rebound from Vorst.
That poor kids missed so much stuff and they weren't bad shots.
Nope.
Murph.
No.
Oh.
They get the rebound though.
Boom.
And the big flush there from Vorst. When that thing parted like the Red Sea, you knew he was going to slam it.
Uh-oh.
Nice steal from Rebels.
I tried to get it off.
Yeah, got the shot off at the buzzer, but it didn't go. But we've got three in the books here in Rossford, and the Bulldogs lead at 31-12.
Different problems require different solutions. Seagate Roofing and Foundation Services has been solving water problems for over 30 years. We have the expertise to provide you with the best solution. Seagate replaces foundations, straightens walls, lifts sinking foundations, and waterproofs basements. Get your free estimate before you make a decision because you deserve to have all the facts. We are the local experts.
244 LEAK Seagate.
It must have worked.
I texted Kale to Kale.
You damn Kentucky fans, I swear to God.
Well, we're getting ready to start quarter number four here. Right now it's all Rossford as they lead this one 31-12. You've got Mike, you've got Mick, and the Hall of Famer, H-O-F-G-F.
H-O-F. Yeah, he's Hoff.
He's the Hoff and the GIF all at the same time.
The David Hasselhoff of us.
The Hoff. Here now is the feed inside.
Oh.
Well, they tried, couldn't get it to go, but.
Genoa boys are beating Woodmore tonight, 48-25 after three. Thank you, HOF. Hoff.
Here's a steal.
All right, Rebels, he's got his lane.
Threw up the teardrop. It didn't fall.
Oh.
Oh, Johnson fell over the ball, and he is hurt.
He turned that ankle.
Yeah, I think he did. He was coming this way, and he fell over, literally fell over the ball.
In himself, basically.
Yep.
That was
it. His body weight took him over, and that was painful. So hopefully he'll be okay.
Oh, he'll be fine. He's mad right now. He's more mad at himself. I'll see what they can do this time.
Yep.
Yeah, right about there is when things go bad.
Well, we'll see.
They get it inside, and then they just... There's Ferguson.
Tucker's in there to replace Johnson. That three does not fall. They can't get anything to fall. It's unfortunate because, like I said, they're fun to watch.
There's Murph.
Nope.
Murph a little short.
And here come the Redmen.
I think the guys still, you know, they're just.
Oh, Tucker waited and drew the contact. But he'll go to the line to shoot two.
Not a lot of fouls tonight, dude.
No, they didn't even reach their bonuses in the first half. And right now, Fostoria only has three fouls. And that was the first foul of the second half for Rossford.
Once again, Thursday night we'll have the Rossford girls taking on Elmwood. We're going to go down there for that. We won't have anything Friday. We might Saturday do the Defiance game. Well, it's all going to depend because 3:30.
Yep.
For the Defiance game. Well, we may be able to do it then because I have to be at. Morris.
Wow.
I have to be at Fallen Timbers for
errant pass. There goes out of bounds.
Krushno Restorations. Holiday party, and I started 6 o'clock for that. So we'll have to see if I can pull that.
That puts you out of here at like 5:30, quarter of six. You realize that? Here's the feed to Rebels. Tries to go wide there on Johnson. Vores from outside. Can't get it to go.
That's his first one he's tried to shoot from out there.
No, he shot one early in the first.
Oh.
And the stuff from Ferguson.
Oh.
Which shows you why he was able to block Vorst in the first quarter.
Yeah. And we're starting to score a little bit here now. Well, the boy's got hops. There's no doubt about that.
Yep.
He was almost head high with that.
Goes strong over Vorst. Can't get it to fall. Nice feed inside.
Oh!
And what you can do, I can do better. Vorst with two stuffs. Ferguson with one. Why do I get the feeling that Ferguson's going to try another one?
Uh-oh.
Here now is Rebels. Three. The third stuff. And a timeout going to be taken.
Well, that was beautiful.
Yeah, that was really nice. As timeout going to be called there from Tom Loomis and the Redmen.
That's a full timeout. We'll take a spot. We'll be right back.
Skyworks is a family-owned and operated business specializing in new and used aerial work platforms, sales, rentals, and service. In addition to aerial lifts, we offer material handling equipment, construction equipment, sales featuring new and used telehandlers, excavators, skid steers, scissor lifts, boom lifts, and forklifts, and much more. Contact Skyworks today, 419-662-8630. Proud sponsor of high school sports in the area.
Well, we've got 4:39 left in this one. This one pretty much well in hand here for Rossford. And of course, after that heartbreaker they had last week, I think this probably feels pretty good to be able to have a game like this.
Well, if I'm Coach Vorse, he probably made him run like 100 suicides, or Michigans, whatever they call them now.
Yeah.
Well, I can honestly say I'm hungry tonight.
Well, that's a good thing.
That's, isn't it?
Yep. Here now is Makai Johnson. Oh, I thought Murphree was going to try and go for the steal. Here now, Ferguson. Bounce pass goes off of Morrison. It'll stay with the Redmen. Horse with the rebound. Nice feed. Oh. Pass did not go as planned.
Going back to Fostoria.
Fostoria, oh. Yep. Yeah, it went off. It went off of Murphree last. Foul will be on Vorst as quiet night for Derek. He's had 13 points. Three of those came on slams.
Yeah, they've been on him pretty hard though.
Yeah, that's the thing. They've really tried to keep him quiet tonight. And for the most part, they have. But he's still going to get some points no matter what. Two for two there for Ferguson. Goes out and it's gonna went last off of Vorst, so they will give it to Fostoria. Long two. Ooh, there you go. Well, they're gonna give him the three. Yeah, my goodness. I thought I saw his foot on the inside the three line. But maybe I'm just old and can't see.
Well, there you go. Because you are old.
This is true. Three attempt from Murphree doesn't go. Another three. Nope. Worse the rebound. Oh, nice. Nice move by Revels, but he loses it, and they'll jump it.
2:46 left to go in this contest, and we'll have one for you Thursday night, and we're trying to get all our sponsors and everything together. The more sponsors we can get, the more games we can do. And yep. It all depends because, you know, Glenn Forbush has gone into free agency now, you know.
Well, of course.
So, you know, we could be
after all, he is the Hall of Famer.
Yes. Hall of Famer Glenn Forbush. We might be losing him. He's actually a little teapot, and he's going tweet, tweet, tweet right now. So,
well, is that what it is?
Yeah, a little hot-headed tonight. Love him like you're my little brother, but
you're the one that had the 102 degree temp this week.
Yes, I did. Oh, nice work inside.
Oh,
hey, missed that one. Well, I am going to get the flu shot. I've never gotten it before, but I'm going to get it. And
nice block from Vorst. But rebound. Well, now it's grabbed here by.
That's all Morrison.
Yep. Three doesn't go as we're under 2 minutes now.
And why not? There you
waffle.
Morrison
with the tray. I love that commercial. You ever see that with Gus Johnson? That tip by Morrison, grabbed by Revels. That he does for.
Alley-oop!
Alley-oop de doop.
Wow. That's his fourth jam. He's face jamming. Everybody's face jam. We have to play that now.
Oh, man.
What are they saying?
Just like football.
Oh,
Garrett Murphree with the Genoa Bank three-point shot. Well, we've got 62 seconds left.
Just like what?
And I think they're going to empty out their benches here and let the younger kids get a little time.
Once again, thanks to all our great sponsors.
Jackson Bridge, number 23, Dylan McCann, number 25, Tinder Kellermeyer, and number 35, Michael Gilbert.
They're bringing them in.
Yep. Well, no, have you ever read or seen the commercial for Hampton Inns? Yeah, with Gus Johnson.
No, I haven't. I probably have.
During Buckeye games and stuff.
Okay.
He does where he's doing me, 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 me. And he's doing all that stuff where they're talking about the big game. Big, big game. And then, like, he's eating breakfast. And just out of nowhere, he just randomly blurts out, waffles. I just love it. I just think that's the funniest thing.
They'll get your medication right one of these days, Mick.
I doubt it.
Just saying.
Another minute to go in this one. Jackson Grimm. Around they go. Mike Gilreth had it, tried to dish it off, but it goes out of bounds. It'll be Fostoria ball.
Checking in for Fostoria 1-0.
Kleinmark checks in here for Fostoria. Derek, a 5'5 junior. Here's a turnover. Xavier Kellermeyer. And that long shot there from Dylan McCann doesn't go.
All the way. Oh. Oh, nice return, reverse.
Nice job there from Xavier Kellermeyer.
Got his names in the books. Another steal.
as the buzzer will sound. And, well, it's a final. So, Rossford bounces back nicely to get a big win here over Fostoria to the tune of 51-20 here on Joe Stalma Court. Mike, any final comments?
Well, I'll tell you this much. Number one, Rossford came and did what they were supposed to do. They dominated the points of the game that they needed to dominate. I think Fostoria came into this game and really had some promise on some good things happening. It just got to get those shots to go down, and it kind of hurt them there. But Rossford played very well, and Morse played. He dominated inside tonight.
Yeah, he did. It was a lot of fun to watch him play. Well, it's going to do it from here at Rossford. Big thanks again to the Hall of Famer, Glenn Forbush. And for my partner, Mike Jameson, I am Mick Gonzalez saying so long, everyone. Your final once again here from Rossford. It was the Bulldogs 51, the Fostoria Redmen 20. You've been watching boys high school basketball right here on the Toledo Sports Network. Good night.